want to do in your life, in your love life. You are not about to settle for anything less than what you want. And let's take a look at the clarifiers. Beautiful reading. Beautiful reading for you. Okay. So why is the King of Swords here for our Pisces friends? King of Swords. King of Swords energy. All right. We have the, oh my gosh, look at this. We have the Queen of Wands twice. So you are very much feeling that you need and want somebody who's fiery. You want somebody who is cool, calm, and collected with that Aquarius energy, infused by Leo energy and Aries energy. So you definitely want somebody with fire in their belly. You are attracting it. Let's see, why do we have the beautiful King of Wands here? Somebody who has the idea of equal give and take. You want someone who's going to be generous with you, and you could be generous with them. We're getting the energy. There you are, Pisces. You want to make a romantic overture towards someone, and we're seeing that somebody's coming in with a bouquet. You're a little bit defensive. You're not sure if the first offer of love is the one that you will take. We also have that you're looking for stability, so you have someone with Capricorn energy coming in to make a love offer. You have love all over the place. My gosh. We also have the King of Wands with the Emperor, who is keeping their options open, but they also are watching you. They're watching you to see what you're up to. Why does our Pisces friends, why do our Pisces friends want all of this fire energy? Sort of an unusual Pisces reading. Two of Wands, you're at a crossroads. You want to be able to make a decision. You want to make a decision after having healed from someone who hurt you. You're in this healing mode currently. Many of you want to move on from a situation that has been painful, something that you may have left a while ago. Ace of Swords, you have great clarity. The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth is what you want. You may have been dealing with someone who was not always clear about what they meant or what they said. The Two of Coins, many of you are willing to date two people simultaneously to find the person that belongs to you. You don't want to waste any time. I'm really seeing this very energetic flow of energy. You want to find your one. Scorpio energy coming out there with the Six of Cups. Many of you are in love with somebody from the past, and you want that to work out. We also get the, you know, the energy here of the Queen of Wands says that you feel as though someone stabbed you in the back, Pisces. You feel as though somebody really energetically stabbed you in the back. I don't think it was through cheating. I don't think it was that way. It looks like it was more like trying to sort of boss you around, like the High Priestess energy trying to teach you a methodology or a thought process or something, you know, almost the way you are thinking. Yeah, see, and you're like, you know what, I have my opinion too. So I do feel as though whoever you were with, you didn't feel defeated by an extra relationship affair. But I do feel as though they sometimes cut you down or made you feel less than. But we see this beautiful Two of Cups here. Look at this energy, the Moon card. Pisces, here you are in the reading. Intuitively, you know that you want someone who's very gentle, who's very sweet. You don't want anybody who is going to surprise you. You are just not, you cannot handle much. We get the Death card and the Tower card. So for many of you, if you're in a connection now, you may break up with it. I mean, the connection may end for new love. So I feel as though some of you are at that precipice of really feeling, making a decision about somebody from the past and that they are really not the one for you so that you can have the one you want. So, because you want this love, you want that, and you're going after it. We have Six of Cups, Two of Cups, Ten of Cups. You have all of this love around you, and you don't know really what happened in the past. You don't really understand why it happened. What's the Strength card here to tell us about our Pisces friends moving forward very rapidly? You have Chariot energy. Pisces, for some of you, you are thinking about the past a lot. while you move into the future, but you do notice that in this reading, the horse is running backwards. Again, you may have feelings, you may contact somebody who was part of your past to reconcile with them. It won't be true for everybody, but it does show that at the very minimum, you know from something that happened in your past love life how to find your Ten of Cups energy. Why is it here? Look at that. You're willing to fight for it. Somebody's willing to fight for you, Pisces. Somebody is not going to. Look at this. As you go backwards into your past, your person's chasing you. So someone is chasing you. Someone's chasing you. But you're a Pisces. Oh, somebody wants to. Somebody wants a do-over. Somebody wants a reconciliation here. It may still happen for some of you. It does look like there's a lot of compatibility. The Star card. Hopes and dreams for love coming true. The Hanged Man. So for some of you, you will go back with somebody from the past or fall in love or make up with somebody from the past. And the reason I say that is you have the Star card with the Hanged Man. But you're going to make them, you're going to work through a problem with them. If your new love is an old love, which for many of you, it will be. We really see you being very discerning. You're going to basically go through a transformation with this person. You're going to have to reestablish the trust. And I feel it's not, again, I don't feel like there's any cheating. There's no juggling. There's no other people that have shown up in this reading with the Three of Swords, Two of Pentacles. But I am seeing that your relationship is going to go through a transformation, and or for absolutely new love, you are going to only choose somebody who's new and different in the ways that you have become aware. So it is a beautiful reading. Let's see what the Moonology deck has in terms of, the Shaman's Dream Oracle has for advice for Pisces in love. Beautiful reading for you, Pisces. Really speaks to a lot of fulfillment. The Star card is your outcome, is hopes and dreams for love coming true. You know, you're beating the drum. You know what you want. You're just taking a quick, deep breath so that you can manifest it. The Hanged Man, you're letting your person come to you. Right use of power. There we go. Let your person come to you. Let them sort through the mess that they created, if that's the case. And if it's brand new love, you are meditation and stillness is your friend in finding a new love. All right, Pisces, it was a joy speaking to you. Thank you for watching the video. I'm so grateful.